Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making a hot brown sandwich. I already have one posted, and it's sort of the kind that you might find in central Kentucky, but it's not the actual version that is used at the Brown Hotel. So recently, Rick and I went on a little field trip and took you all along in case you came. And we went to the Brown Hotel, and I did order the hot brown sandwich so I could see it up close. But while we were there, just kind of killing some time before our meal, we happened by one of their cafes, and they had a little leaflet on the hot brown sandwich, tell a little bit about the history, which I mentioned to you before. It was kind of born out of the idea of the 1,200 people or so who were dancing at night being hungry, and the chef came up with this as a solution to their hunger at the English Grill. So we had our dinner at the English Grill, but I was able to pick up the actual recipe that is used for the hot brown. Now, I don't think they follow it exactly like this because I noticed they have Texas toast and mine wasn't. What I ordered did not have it. So I'm going to make it true to what I ate based on the ingredients that are listed here. So we start out by making a Mornay sauce. It's just like a white sauce that has Romano cheese. And the type of Romano cheese is Pecorino. Now, I don't know if that's important to this particular flavor. When I make hot brown, I will use cheddar cheese or Parmesan or whatever I have on hand, and it always tastes good. But this is kind of a special taste for the Mornay sauce. You need, for what we're making, which is one sandwich, you need 1 tablespoon of butter. And I've already melted it. And to that, you're gonna add 2 tablespoons of flour. And I have my flour sitting here at self-rising, but it doesn't need to be for a recipe like this. I just need some thickening. So I'm going to stir these together. And you'll see that it will be a little lumpy. You can actually put this on the stove and cook it as you stir it and make a nice roux. But I think that is a little more error prone for most cooks. So I'm just suggesting you make a paste of it and then put in your liquid. And the liquid in this case is 1 pint of whipping cream. So it's heavy cream and we need 2 cups or 1 pint. So I'm going to pour that in. Then we'll go to the stove and we will thicken this up. So it needs to be cooked over low heat and stirred continually until we have a nice white sauce, and then we'll turn it into Mornay sauce. All you need to do is to let this simmer for about 2 or 3 minutes, and you have this nice, lovely cream sauce. So we're going to turn this off, and then bring this over to my workspace. You can see the sauce a little closer now, and we're going to turn it into Mornay sauce. The Romano cheese that is used here is Pecorino Romano cheese, and it just takes a little bit. You can see it's very compact, but I need 1/4 cup. Remember, I'm just making one sandwich worth, and this is a lot of sauce, and for my taste, it's probably too much for one sandwich, but we'll see how it goes. We're using 1/4 finely shredded, and I just used the kitchen shredder. You can see the shred still left there on the tiny part. Now, it doesn't have to be tiny. If you want to turn around and use the other part, it's going to melt anyway. So it just goes in here. And also, I reserved 1/2 tablespoon for the topping. If I'd been making 2 sandwiches, which is the way the recipe is written, then I would have reserved 1 tablespoon for the toppings of the 2 sandwiches. So I will write it up for 2 sandwiches because that's what my card says, but I'm just making enough for 1 sandwich, and as heavy as this is with cream and with the cheese and all, my husband and I do not eat that heavily, except on occasions like when we go to the Brown Hotel and are served that way. So you just let this melt a little bit, and you have your Mornay sauce. It does need to be seasoned, so just take some pepper. White pepper would be nice actually here, but there are a lot of colors on this, so I wouldn't worry about the dark pepper. And then some salt. and just shake them to your taste. So you season it up with salt and pepper. Stir that in. It's a nice, cheesy, lovely sauce to go over the hot brown sandwich, as was originally intended. So I'm going to set this spoon aside. It's kind of big and awkward. And talk about the bread a little bit. Now, in the recipe that was printed on the card, it said to use Texas toast. But like I said earlier, mine did not come on Texas toast. So I chose a white bread, but it's called Farmhouse Soft Hearty White Bread. So it's just a little bit healthier than your typical soft white bread. You're going to toast that, which I've already done, and then I decided to remove the edges. Actually, I think I did that. These are the edges. I did that before I toasted it. It doesn't really matter. It's probably easier to do it ahead of time, and then when you get it toasted, you're going to divide it into triangles. So let's go corner to corner with a knife, and then you can split this however you want. Well, I'd like to make it symmetric, so I'm going to go corner to corner. So try to do this. And those points point outward. So after you get it cut with your knife, then turn your toast points around. Two of them can go that way, and then the other two can go this way. Now, it doesn't really matter, I'm sure, whatever arrangement you want to put them in. Bring these in a little closer, because what's going to go on the bottom there will be our turkey. So we might as well move to that point. And right here, I have some turkey, which was left over from Thanksgiving. This is a good use for turkey if you have it stored away in the freezer from having your Thanksgiving dinner, or if you have it for any reason, or if you want to go to the deli and buy a sliced turkey. Any of those will be fine. This calls for, I think, 7 ounces for each sandwich. So I'm putting about the amount that I found on my sandwich in here, and it was overlapped, so I'm going to put a little bit here on the bottom, and then on top of that, I'm going to put the rest of it. So that's a good probably 8 ounces or so of turkey. Then the next thing we're going to do is take a Roma tomato, and then I'll just take the end off that, get rid of it. I want to slice it in half, so I'm just coming straight down and getting two halves that are pretty much identical, and then those will be placed wherever you like, but kind of across from each other. Maybe at the juncture here, and then straighten this up a little bit, the juncture here. Some kind of style that you like, where you will have the two tomatoes across from each other and include your bread points pointing outward. At this point, we're ready to put the sauce on top. So we just actually drenched the thing in sauce. And I'm going to stop short of using all of this if I feel like it's something I won't eat in a sandwich, that if it's just way too much, and actually it already is telling me it's way too much for me. My husband and I probably will split this sandwich anyway. So just take your Mornay sauce and go over the top and even over the tomatoes. I guess we are going to use it all. Well, not quite. I just don't feel good about putting the rest of that in, so that's coming back here. So I'm going to take this to the oven, and I have the oven set to broil, so we're going to be broiling it probably about 5 or 6 inches away from the broiling unit. And then I'll bring it back and we'll finish it up. This is the way your hot brown sandwich looks after you get it out from under the broiler. But it has a few more things that happen with it. That reserved little bit of Pecorino Romano cheese goes right at the center there at the top. So it's just a garnish, really, and it has some flavor. And then, this is crucial to a hot brown, you take two crisp pieces of bacon and you crisscross them in the center. Let me see the best way to do that. Another thing I'm going to do is put some paprika on here. We have some paprika that we'll just shake over the entire top. And then the final touch is a little greenery. So we have some parsley. Let me save out some of this. I might want to put it along the edge. But I'm going to just snip this and let it fall where it may. This is your finished hot brown sandwich made in the way that the Brown Hotel makes it.